Hello my dear Rubians, welcome back to our channel Ruby's Lovely World. How are you guys doing? Hope everybody is doing really great. I'm absolutely fine and doing good. So today's video is going to be a recipe video, a mango and coconut chutney. This is really tasty guys, I love this chutney. Luckily I found mangoes somebody gave us and I made this chutney. So I'm sharing the recipe with you guys, hope you guys also like it. So without further delay, let's go ahead into the video. For this chutney, you would require coconut. So I have taken half coconut in grated form and those two small mangoes, I have chopped them into small pieces. Green chilies about 6 to 8. You also need garlic pods. So first I am frying few ingredients first, for which I have taken a pan and added some oil. In this I have added 2 tablespoons of zeera. Sorry, 2 teaspoons of zeera. And then chopped green chilies. About 10 to 15 garlic pods, peel the skin and then use them in the chutney. Slightly roast until the rawness is gone. You can keep it on the medium flame and roast them well like this. Now we will be grinding all the ingredients together. So in a blending jar, add the chopped mango pieces, grated coconut and also the zeera and green chilies and garlic. You can add dhania seeds also. I don't have dhania seeds currently, so I have added dhania powder. So we need to blend all these ingredients together. I have added salt at the same time so that will get mixed well. Salt is as per your taste guys. So once you pulse it, you have to pulse it about 4-5 times because we are not adding water. You have to pulse it about 4-5 times and this is how the consistency of the chutney should be. Now we'll go ahead and give the tempering to this chutney, for which again I used the same pan. Added some zeera and cumin seeds, that is zeera, cumin seeds, mustard seeds and urad dal. Lightly roast them until golden brown. I'm not using any red chilies here, but if you want you can add few red chilies in the tempering. So finally, before taking it down, I've just added some curry leaves. Once the curry leaves splatter, you can add the ground mixture of the chutney into the same pan and mix them well together for another minute. You can check the taste and add the salt accordingly if you have added less or more, otherwise it should be fine. So mix the tempering along with the chutney completely. And that's it guys, our mango and coconut chutney is ready. This you can have it for breakfast, lunch with rice or roti and all, if with anything this tastes good. Because this will be sour and with the green chilies it will be spicy also, very nice. It tastes good with rice also. So our chutney is ready and that's a very simple and easy recipe. Hope you guys will try it. Do give it a try and let me know how you guys find this guys. And that's it for today's video guys. Hope you like it. And please like, share and subscribe to our channel. If you have already subscribed, then do not forget to hit the notification button. Click the bell icon so that you'll be notified whenever we upload our new videos on our channel. So guys, that's it for today's video. Hope you guys like it and I'll be getting back to you with more exciting videos on my channel. Stay tuned and also share with your loved ones to provide more support, and thank you for all the support that you have provided so far. And for all the new subscribers, welcome to our channel guys, and I'll get back to you guys with another video. Thank you so much for watching. Take care. Bye bye.